looking at the latest Newspoll analysis, it shows the government's taken a bit of a hit in a few different areas in the West, with younger voters and with male voters. Joining me live in the studio is the Australian's political editor, Simon Benson. Simon, great to see you as always. Thanks for coming in on this Easter Monday. But it's some interesting analysis off the back of the first quarter, isn't it? It's not saying the coalition can win, but a minority looking likely for the government.
Yeah, look, there's a bit to unpack in this, and this is the beauty of the sort of the demographic analysis over a couple of months. You know, you have a longer period to dig into what's really going on behind the main numbers. You know, if you step back and look at it, 52-48 still in Labor's favour. That's unchanged from the final quarter of last year. So on the surface, it looks like status quo, but digging into it, you see some significant shifts in WA. You know, around 6% swing in WA towards the coalition. So for the first time, the coalition are in front in WA, the head of Labor. So that's significant. But then again, it shouldn't be surprising. I think people probably tend to forget that Labor secured a 10.5% swing in WA at the last election, which got them over the line. So that, you know, that's a high watermark for Labor. So coming off is not really a surprise, particularly Mark McGowan gone. Scott Morrison not in the picture anymore, you know, you have those sort of perennial battles in WA. GST's become an issue again lately. The fight over that usually ignites the passions a bit over there. So, look, it's significant, but I don't think it's surprising that's happened in WA. What is a little surprising is the younger voter demographic. That's come off quite a bit. 6 points off Labor in the 18 to 34 year olds, and you'd sort of think that would normally churn over to the Greens, but it hasn't this time, and it's gone into the Liberal column, the Liberal Nationals column. The Liberal Nationals were coming from a pretty dire position originally amongst that age group, so it's going from dire to not so bad. Significantly, it's ahead of the Greens now in that demographic. You know, I wouldn't, out of these polls, you're reluctant to assign any single policy to a shift, but you'd have to say in that age group, cost of living vis-a-vis renting would be a huge factor.
Absolutely. Mm. You look at, for that generation as well, getting into a house, renting, the HEX bills are higher than our generation paid. They're also got to chip in more for the ageing demographic. Things are not easy for the younger generation, let alone that dream of one day getting a house for themselves.
Oh, absolutely, absolutely.
This is one of the main political equations right now. Who can sway? And I guess Max Chandler Mather of the Greens is quite potent when it comes to that demographic.
True. I mean, going back to my original point on the not drawing a single policy out of it, and I think you can be assured that cost of living is the primary driver of most of these shifts in Newspoll. But there is an interesting correlation, I suppose, and we can get to the male vote as well. But we did a poll a couple of polls ago in early March, that you'll remember, on nuclear. And there was a very significant support for nuclear in that 18 to 34-year-old group and amongst men. And coincidentally, they're the two groups that have shifted in this cycle. I'm not saying that would be the driver of it, but you couldn't discount that possibility that the coalition have finally found a policy that resonates in an age group that certainly hasn't favoured them.
And the male voters, you've got that number there, up 3. Female voters down. Again, you don't want to go to one particular policy, but it's just an interesting look at where the trends are at right now.
Yeah, the male voters is curious. I mean, I'm assuming that's probably a general disillusionment. Female voters, I think, in the last quarterly analysis showed that it turned against Labor, and there's a general feeling amongst pollsters that female voters are far more sensitive to cost of living issues. So that wasn't a surprise then. Perhaps just takes men a while to catch up on it.
Yeah.
But again, I think that probably just points to a general disillusionment. The caveat on all this, of course, is that it didn't cover the last week of Parliament.
No.
And so I, you know, I'm hesitant to suggest that this is a locked-in thing. And the last poll in this cycle was, you remember we discussed last week, had come back to 51-49, which was the start of a potential trend against Labor. If that were to continue in the next cycle, then going back to your point about minority government certainly becomes something to talk about.
It's possible.
Seriously.
But majority government is still possible, as you've written in the newspaper today. And in fact, this is nowhere near where the coalition needs to be to win government. And some have said to you that they're wondering why aren't the coalition doing better given the problems Labor's had?
Well, considering the problems they've had, there are a few in the coalition, certainly in the party room, that sort of think, well, maybe we should be doing better. But I suppose in the absence of policy, and there is a big absence of policy on the coalition side, there's not a lot for people to be drawn to, I suppose, at this stage. So perhaps that might be the argument that Peter Dutton would mount, that just wait till we've got some policy on the table and things will shift in their favour. But you're right, there is a pathway to majority government for Anthony Albanese. I think the next poll will be critical in sort of talking to this possibility of minority government, which is, again, if we talk about it again in another 4 weeks, we're talking about another aspect of this whole debate, and that's the Hobson's choice for Albanese, that if they do go to minority government, who do they go with, the Greens or the Independents?
Indeed. Simon, great to chat about that, as you said, a very interesting analysis across the first quarter of Newspoll. We'll see you soon. Appreciate it.